Julian in Nicomedia. He courted danger recklessly, with trivialities, espoused degenerate Greek ideas, pagan adulteries and abnormalities. He would go visiting heathen shrines, temples to the old ones, endlessly seeking miracles and signs. Was always talking with Chrysanthius, the lucubrations of Maximus of Ephesus. What's the outcome? He frays the nerves of Gallus, arouses the suspicions of Constantius. He was badly advised and led astray. Mardonius ardently begged him to delay, to try to be more pious in a Christian way. At last he reluctantly listens, begins to obey his careful tutor, though even then quite fey about it all, as though to say, "Do I have to?" Thank God, caution won the day. He returns as lay reader to the church, where, with earnest countenance and unremitting reverence, and not a trace of his usual arrogance, he reads from Holy Writ in a voice so loud, so clear, with that assumed look of wholesome innocence his auditors hold dear.